Well, that's enough rambling. Let's get on to game one here. We're looking at a potentially fairly long series after all. So, let's get started. So this first one's going to be a PvP. Crazy Chaos is known for playing a lot of different raises. He hasn't really, like, nailed one down yet. But it looks like we're going to be starting off in the land of cloaks and daggers.
Crazy Chaos. I like that name. Prime Terraces as well. Huh? Is this... Wait, what races are there? I didn't even see.
PvP. Protoss versus Protoss, according to the lobby menu.
Oh, okay. Anyway. I thought Crazy Chaos went random.
Yeah. But he picked Protoss, according to the lobby. So, bottom of the map, we have our teal said Protoss player. It is Coral Rays of Chaos from Sea Rage.
Sea Rage. Ah, nice. Alright. There you go. Well, in the top, Brian Terrace, of course, is the pink, many pink Protoss. It is DJ Lingling's, i.e. Leaf Cena in the chat.
Yeah, Leaf Cena, by the way, actually played his first multiplayer game in a show match, if you can believe that.
Yeah, dude, like, dude, it's amazing.
Hell.
Ballsy, like, because, like...
Not too many people would do that. But he enjoyed it, and he's still here, so that says something, right?
Yeah, dude, like, it's awesome. Like, most people don't really play StarCraft all that much because, you know, it's a little, like, stressful and all that, or whatever. So I myself have... Yeah,
we got a probe across the map, and we have a forge building back home. Now, here's the thing. There's a gateway coming up as well, so he may not necessarily be going for a cannon rush, but that does immediately pop to mind as a potential. Nope, he's not going for it. He's going to just back off. But okay. The only reason why I was edging toward that discussion is that still, PvP is one of those places where the cannon rush still has a lot of strength. It's gotten significantly weaker in the other two matchups. But not so much here.
Yeah. Well, looks like Crazy Chaos is actually not going... I thought I was going to build a pylon on like, the low ground and cannon that up, and then like go on the high ground, and then do it again. But yeah, looks like he's just going to, you know, just hang back, just go to some random location elsewhere. And, you know, both guys just going to go for an expansion of their own, just going to take their naturals, not their golds at the third. So, you know, just gonna play it safe.
We're looking at a fast expand, and he's proxying a pylon, actually, a little bit to the north. I'm guessing probably for some hidden tech. I mean, you wouldn't really, if you were trying to go for, like, the Karassi-style pylons, you don't really put those on your half the map, typically.
Yeah. Very cheeky.
Just a simple positioning pylon. You could actually use these defensively, if you think about it. Like, just have a warp in that flanks the enemy position.
Yeah.
If it works. Yeah.
Yeah. If it works, then yeah, totally.
Both players actually getting their cyber cores at about the same time. Pretty late too, surprisingly enough.
Yeah, kinda. Well, it looks like Leaf Cena again a little bit supply blocked. Can't really do terrible lot for now, but looks like he's gonna start up an expansion right now. And I'm not sure. Let's go over to Crazy Chaos Land. I'm not sure what this. I'm not entirely sure what this forge. Was actually four cannons.
You know, he might have thrown it down, thinking that maybe I'll go for it, and changed his mind when he got there. Or he wanted to have some quick cannon defenses.
Ah, and then he thought, you know, well, don't really need them, so.
Yeah.
You know,
just, one of the things I've always liked to say is, oh, by the way, he's going for a fast Stargate. That's pretty clear what his plan is now. But anyway,
my goodness.
But yeah, that like here's the thing I like to look at. Whenever you're looking at games below silver, or at silver even, you kind of want to think in terms of shapes. Because usually the person that sits down, they have a shape of a plan, right? Mass void rays, or I want to make a lot of DTs, or whatever. And that's the thing that's thought out. When that doesn't work, pure chaos will break loose. Or they win with it. Or the other person like blind counters it. But,
they're just
you
like
know.
they're just like a dog with like a chemistry set, and they're just like, dude, I know what I'm doing.
Basically, there's one plan. There is one plan, and there's no other plan. So if that plan breaks or falls apart,
I don't know. I guess I'm just
the best
making
games
a lot
of
this unit.
Born.
Yeah, hey, it's like.
Would you say it would end up in Crazy Chaos?
No, I would. Yeah, sure. The other thing that you'll see is that a lot of excess resources that happens. Probably happen on both sides. So far, Crazy Chaos actually having done a remarkably good job of keeping his resources low, though maybe falling a little bit behind in the work production territory.
Ooh, a Void Ray. There's a Void Ray coming out. Yeah,
he's
also got a Twilight Council. Yeah, he's got a Twilight Council. I was looking forward to seeing some DTs, actually, you know, but looks like the Twilight Council is, again, just for decoration. Wants to decorate the...
It's part of the plan later.
He wants to make his proto-civilization look good, you know? Basically, it's basically playing SimCity right now, like literal SimCity.
That's how SimCity Protoss work, right? Like, you have a whole caste system governing what jobs people have, so you would know that you have so many workers and so many warriors, right? And also, you'd have to set the infrastructure according to that.
Mm.
And then your natural disasters would be replaced by, like, Zerg invasions.
Yeah.
That's a thing that you could probably do, but I wonder how interesting it would be. At the very least, I would love to have like a skin for City Skylines that turns all the buildings into Protoss structures. That would be kind of cool.
That would be super cool, because like the all the Protoss buildings and stuff, they're like so shiny, right?
Yeah.
They just look so round and elegant and shiny and stuff. Hell yeah.
So far we have a lot of gateways for Leaf Sina. It's mostly just getting Zealot Stalker up. Nice positioning, though. I like the Gateway Army and the Mothership Corps being right on the ramp like this. Makes it pretty easy to respond to either drop to the right or attack the ramp. At the same time, we have Crazy Chaos kind of embracing the idea that Void Rays are good, and he's just making a lot of Void Rays and getting Blink.
Uh-oh. Oh, snap. this is... Dude, mass Void Rays, dude. Like, I just miss the days. Like, remember when mass Void Rays were the most broken-ass, like, thing ever? But that was like, actually, in bronze and silver. Like, that was, like, in Super Low League, yeah.
I think that was, like, a little bit before I started playing. But I did get to gold that way, I'm pretty sure, actually.
Well, just making Void Rays and nothing
else. Yeah, it works really well against people that make mistakes.
Turns out. Yeah, they don't expect that shit.
I mean, and then you run into Zergs that have, like, back then it was Infestors. They would just nail your Void Rays, and you'd be like, well, okay. And then watch them all die.
Oh, so sad.
And that's where you kind of went, I guess I need a different plan. You'd stop making them. We have a Fleet Beacon coming down.
Yep.
Wow. Now. Maybe Carriers? I mean, they're good in this game. So
Tempest,
sure.
Dude, it's all about the Tempest. I mean, he could go for Carriers potentially, but like, you know, I just want to see Tempest, dude. They're just like one of my favorite units in the game.
They are really cool looking.
Yeah, I used to do Tempest Rush like city strats. Like,
I like this. We've seen a starting to throw down more gateways. If you ever find yourself in this situation where you have way too many resources, it's 100% okay to throw down way too many production buildings. That's the only way you're going to fix that problem. If you have exactly the number of production buildings that you can support per base, you will never catch up.
Pretty much.
Gotta overproduce.
Exactly. I mean, yeah, he does have a game-winning bank right there, you know? Just, you know, gotta get those, get the stalkers there, and there we are, you know? Yeah. Oh, this is a very interesting tech choice from Crazy Chaos. He's actually going for a Phoenix range upgrade, and he doesn't really have that many Phoenixes out in the field. It's just Void Rays, so, yeah.
I wonder if that's a misclick. It does look really similar to the old Mothership.
Uh-oh. Oh, snap. Well,
so I guess
wait
the only thing that's better
them.
Than Void Rays is Cloaked Void Rays, right?
Oh, snap. Yeah, I mean, especially
this Void Ray army is actually getting a little scary. If he gets too many more of these things, he can actually just walk up to that Stalker armory, hit E, and they will kill everything before
the
Void Ray dies.
They just melt. It's gross. Dude, yeah, they just, you know. Oh, there's an army here? Oh. What army?
And blinking against void rays is surprisingly difficult as well.
Yeah.
Like, you pretty much have to grab the unit and blink immediately. You don't wait for them to run out of shields because they'll just die.
Pretty much. Yeah. I mean, when I see people do that, like, I just go straight for Archons. Like, Archons just can't stand because, like, they just don't. Like, yeah, void rays are just really bad versus Archons, so. Yeah. If it gets really dicey, I just go for Storms, but. Yeah.
But
like,
yeah.
If you see shit like this, it's really easy to scout.
About the fleet beacon there. Yeah, the reason I was saying that might be like a misclick is just the. That symbol and the carrier interceptor thing, they actually look almost the same. So it's entirely possible that if you wanted the carrier upgrade, you might have just clicked on the wrong one.
Yeah, you just. I've seen pros do
that a couple times even. Not common. Like, they usually do it the other way. They'll get the interceptor one when they want the Phoenix one, but it happens.
Yeah, dude, you gotta play fast, man. You're under pressure. You're on TV right now, dude. Like, we're here. We are here with our eyes. And it's not just our eyes. It's everyone in the chat is looking at your game right now. And they're scrutinizing every single one of your mistakes. Like, be glad that we got a no backseating rule.
So I like throwing the occasional probe out to get some scouting information. He hasn't been able to see a lot with it. Probably would work a little better with maybe, like, just a couple sentries to build up energy for hallucinations. But, still, you know, I like the attempt, getting a little bits of information. Nothing else. Seeing the same gateway army just kind of sitting there tells you that something else is going on most of the time.
Oh my goodness.
I get so nervous if I scan, like, a ball of zerglings over again and over again and over again. They're just never getting any bigger. And I'm not seeing anything else. I'm like, oh god,
what is going on, man? Like, maybe it's just like Lings into like ultras or something. Like, you get nothing but Lings up until the half deck. Now,
yeah,
and that could happen.
It could be. Yep, I would be very well familiar with that possibility now.
Yep, I know, man. I think I've seen that strategy somewhere.
I know. Like, maybe just a few minutes. Maybe just like an hour ago or something. Though that was a solid play, I gotta say, on Otter's part, though. That caught me completely off guard. I failed to scout it entirely, and when they showed up, I was like, well, I'm dead. Okay.
Oh, yeah, that was
I rough. Can't
yeah.
kill these things fast enough.
Yeah, like, if you didn't have the right stuff to deal with that, like, nah, you're dead. It's like, nah, you're dead. You're gone. Oh, look at this crazy chaos. You know, players are just doing the good old strategy. It's the I like to call this the Wild West standoff strategy, where
the ninja third.
Yeah.
Okay. I mean, obviously,
you gotta hide that shit, man.
There's one weakness of a ninja base, right? And the one weakness of a ninja base is your opponent just builds a normal one. Because they don't have to transfer their workers halfway across the map, and there's no vulnerability to it, so they just have this base that they could mine from faster. In which case, it happens to also be a gold base. Not that, you know, we've seen it struggling for minerals or anything, but now he really won't be struggling for minerals for a long time.
Yeah. I mean, like, yeah, that's true. Well, looks like there's a Dark Shrine coming up for Crazy Chaos, so, you know, he's just building up.
Yeah.
This is kind of, I wonder how this is going to pan out. Like, this is, so far this game has been going on for 13 and a half minutes. We have seen next to no action, and right now we're seeing a Dark Shrine halfway complete.
This is the variation of low-level games that you sometimes see, where players, their plan was to build a big army. And they're building a big army.
He proxied the Stargate. Didn't really do anything with it.
He hid his tech from potential scouting, but the scouting never got into the base, so it was probably not necessary. But
yeah, honestly though,
in
like
hindsight,
if you place your Stargate like this, like, it means it's basically saying, I want to attack you and I want to attack you soon, right? Like.
Yeah, pretty much.
Alright,
you would usually expect at least like an oracle out of it because you get a real nice angle coming up the side.
Mm-hmm.
But, meh. No big deal. We have double colossi production. And there are 5 Colossi and a giant number of Stalkers. Oh, this is like a Wings of Liberty build.
Kinda cool. Colossi Stalkers? Stalker.
Well, you got that shoots up and stuff that kills everything on the ground. What else do you need?
Dude, I wonder how they're gonna fare against an army of Death Rays. GG Rays.
The problem here is that I don't think they're gonna be able to get to the mothership.
Pretty much. Oh, yeah. I mean, yeah, I don't think Cena actually realizes it's just making Colossi and Stalkers and basically nothing else. It'll be interesting to see how this pans out. I don't think that we're gonna see any action sometime soon. So how's your day?
My day's been good, man. Real good. Progress in Diablo 3 for that set that makes you look like a ninja on the Demon Hunter.
Oh yeah.
So now I'm running around with the throwing knife ability because I can't use the bow anymore. But it's good. I like it.
Oh snap! Yeah, I like Demon Hunter a lot. I like the dudes where you have to run around and kite and maneuver and shit. The Demon Hunter is my jam, dude. Wizard's my favorite class.
I think Leaf Sina should win this. But it might come down to whether or not he remembers to hit the E key with the Void Rays.
Yeah, this is gonna be close because Crazy Cats doesn't actually have any. He doesn't have any observers out in the field, so he can't actually see.
Oh no! Here comes the fight. Now he sees his tiny gateway army, and there's a ton of stuff here. Void Rays are really good, turns out, even without charge. And he's gonna blink under, go for the mothership core, does take it out, but there's still a ton of other air units in the air, and I think he's killed almost all the anti-air. Now
Rays, not too strong.
Goes everything. And the Colossi fall next. He got the skill beams. There we go. And that's it.
And then it's done, man. You got one punch, dude. You got taken out in one punch.
One punch, man.
Yeah, one punch! Oh, bloody hell.
He's basically like a character that's in Diablo 3 that's tuned for Torment 10, but he's trapped in Master difficulty. So he just kills everything in one hit. He's like, I can't! Nothing is... it's so easy now! Why? Yeah, Void Rays, they pretty much have that relationship with Stalkers. I would actually say that
just
either
press
of them...
a button and you win.
Either of them probably could have, I think you could have technically kept going after that fight, because he could have warped in another round of Stalkers back home, maybe killed that off.
Yeah.
It's not like Crazy Chaos actually had the production to rebuild all the air he lost.
Yeah. It did have quite a lot of game. I mean, Stalkers just wouldn't, Stalkers would just lose straight up. You need either more Void Rays, which is, that's not possible, or you need Archons, which you can't get. You can't really get them because it doesn't really have anything to make them really. And you wouldn't have had anything for a long time. So yeah, if you see 6 Death Rays coming for your base, then it's over. It's over.
Yeah,
I hope Cena gets him next game.
But still, Leaf, though, I gotta say that it's better to have too much money like that and lose, because that it's real easy to solve that problem. Just build more production. Good, you got an economy to back it up. That's not a bad problem to have, at where you are right now, in StarCraft. But alright, it looks like for game 2, Crazy Chaos is switching to Terrans. This one's going to be a PvT.
PvT. Oh, man. Well, I wonder how this is going to go. Ooh, so he is random, huh? Where he's just actually making sure that it's random.
He's random, but choosing kind of outside of it. He's just not playing one race consistently.
Yeah, now this is interesting. Note the race and the map. This is all Rena, and it's Terran. Is he going to do the cheeky thing? No, it is not.
No. Okay. Yeah, he might just go for drops. It's cheeky enough, frankly, on this map.
Yeah, it's really easy, because, like, yeah, it's just, the bases are just, like, you know, so close together.
Well, anyway, we should probably introduce the players properly. In the bottomless part of the map, we have
Yes.
our Teal Terran player this time. It is Crazy Chaos, currently ahead by one game.
Crazy. Chaos. Uh-oh. Gassing it up. Oh, going for Mega Play probably. And in the top, it is the pink Protoss. It is Lingling's, i.e. Leafseener in the chat. Unfortunately, he's still in the chat room. Oh, no,
Yeah,
he is. Look at
he's here.
that. He says, you can do that. Oh, I'm not sure what that is they're referring to.
I think he didn't realize you could make a mothership core into a mothership.
Oh,
Judging by
yeah.
the conversation. Frankly speaking, by the way, on that note, if you're super far ahead and it's a really late game, that is a good idea. 90% of the time, it's better to just leave it like that, though, because most of its primary functions are going to be defensive or for recalling your army. Like the cloak function at the time of the game that you get it, usually people have detection, so it doesn't really help you all that much. But it's way more inexpensive to rebuild a mothership core. Basically, if you never built the mothership, then you can rebuild the mothership core 4 times, roughly.
Yeah,
So it's a good
like,
unit, but it has some drawbacks.
doesn't it lose an ability if it turns into a mothership as well? Like,
I don't think
I think it does.
so anymore. I think it
Oh
used
yeah,
to. I
I
think they
think
put
it.
it back in, I'm pretty sure.
Oh yeah. Oh, that's
But
true. That's true.
I gotta double check. We didn't exactly look while we were playing the last
That's
match.
true. Yeah, I
But
just checked
yeah,
the help menu.
I'm
It
pretty
just.
sure it used to lose. Was it Time Warp or
It
Photon
used to.
Overcharge?
Photon over, yeah, I lost Photon Overcharge. That was in Hearts, I believe.
Yeah.
That was like,
But now it doesn't lose any function, so if you have the minerals and gas for it, yeah, knock yourself out.
Alright, here we go. Looks like Reaper coming out for Crazy Chaos. Gonna go and do a little bit of scouting. Ling-Ling's is just gonna go for a cheeky early
Oh,
expansion.
we know what Crazy Chaos is all about. We know why he's picked Terran. You see it in the production bar, don't you? He's going for fun times.
Now that's, I mean, dude, that is legit. I gotta say, that
Yeah.
actually happened in the pro match in DreamHack.
Nice.
Yeah, like you thermal, micro thermal. Like he did that versus Showtime, and yeah, he actually won that because like it's not easy for Paralysis to get detection. Like you need to get into Robo and then Observer, and like he just didn't see that shit coming like at all, right? So
Yeah.
there were just like ghosts and stuff just picking off probes,
The thing
like one
is,
at a time.
I think he's trying to nuke him.
Yeah, no,
Truth be
that would be
told,
a
the thing that scares me
factory.
most about this building when I see it in a PVT is that I've encountered a couple all-ins in the beta in particular. I haven't actually seen them since then, where you just grab a few ghosts and obliterate the shields and kill the army really quickly.
Oh yeah, like EMP and stuff.
Surprisingly good.
Yeah,
But
I.
the thing is, it's not very common, so I don't know if it's like if it was just a one and done deal or if that's like a legit build or not.
That's interesting, because I tried doing something like that actually, because like, what Protosses like to do, and for example, on like a map, like Protosses, right? They just get a fast gold, and then they put 3 pylons, and they do the 3 pylon like defense, all that stupid shit. So.
You know what it was? I just realized it. It was when the Adepts were stronger. Because it ripped off half the, like more than half of the Adept's health bar.
Oh
So when they
yeah.
used to have like the health of a roach, that was a good way of basically killing mass Adept players.
Yeah.
And yeah, it worked at that. It did a good job at that. But I don't know. I guess it's still technically a sound idea. Just you're right. The pylon defenses make that tricky. We'll have to see what happens once this balance patch goes through.
Oh, balance. Uh-oh.
Yeah,
Well, in the
they're
meantime,
modifying a
doesn't
few
nuke.
things, but you know. In the meantime, we
Nuclear
have a two
missile.
base versus two base scenario. There's a nuclear missile.
Oh yeah, and the reactor actually going down on the factory, so there's gonna be mines up in here, man. Because you know mines are pretty good versus versus
Aliens.
Protoss. Hellions,
Yep.
hellions,
Yep.
hellions.
Yep.
Ooh,
Oh.
that's something I haven't seen in a little while.
That can be really good against Protoss, actually. because a lot of Protosses do not encounter this very often, like run by Temps Battalions. So if you can get the Protoss off guard slightly, they'll just obliterate everything.
Oh, no, that's true, because, like, in PBT, like, Protosses, I don't see many Protosses actually wall off, because, you know, because you don't need to wall off versus an army that shoots from afar, right? Like, so, yeah. So, no, Hellions are good in that respect, but, you know.
Well, I mean, part of it is just that you're either respecting the Marines or you're respecting the Hellions. If you're respecting the Marines, you don't put important structures at your ramp, because they'll shoot them. But if you're respecting Hellions, then yeah, you wall them out. Kind of depends on what you're worried about.
Respect. You gotta respect them, bro. You gotta give them the respect they deserve.
Exactly. Ooh, I like the positioning of this Widow Mine. If he takes a direct route across here with an army, it's gonna take some splash damage before the fight even takes place.
Yeah, hell yeah, dude. Widow Mines are just delicious, man. I love Widow Mines.
Cloak is almost
done. I hate playing against them, because, you know, like, honestly, like, it's just, like, yeah, like when you get, like, good shots of a Widow Mine, it just feels like you were lucky, in a way, instead of, like, you doing something really cool, right? Like, some cool-ass, like, Migrant stuff.
Colossi in range coming up.
Oh, snap. Sir, well, that's not going to be done for, like, 50 seconds, and meanwhile, there's an army coming in.
He's walking forward with the ghost. The ghost is now close.
Oh my god, the army was a decoy. Here.
Offensive nuke going down. It's landing right on top of the army. As long as these dudes can stay there long enough, nope, everyone's gonna leave. It's gonna kill a few probes, probably.
Well, the counter to a nuke is that you just go forward. Oh my god, what the hell?
Oh yeah.
Oh my god.
Oh, he really should just walk that guy up there with some probes. Meanwhile, on the other side of the map, we have three Protoss units fighting in a choke point.
Several. It's like a Colossus, an Immortal, and a Stalker.
Nope, the Ghost is coming back. Hero Ghost is coming back to save his hometown. He's kind of running out of energy, though. He actually only has 19 energy left. So he's about to lose his cloak, but he probably will kill or damage at least one unit before that happens.
Oh, TFW, you get boned by a Stalker, a Colossus. Like, this is...
Oh, no, he's uncloaked now. Violent, awful death. Who wants the Widow Mine? I'm going to try and save the day.
Literally three people.
Plant him on the rat. Yep, three people are murdering a human colony.
This is like... Yeah, this is like a bank robbery, dude. It's
boom!
Like,
got one.
Oh, look at that. Well, it's still
stray
like,
shot comes in and kills the driver.
It's the death army. Oh, my God.
There we go. And boom.
And
set the monster course still here.
And two Marines save the day. Oh yeah, good job, Private.
I got that wrong. The mothership core is clearly the driver in this scenario. The recall.
Meanwhile,
you know, Crazy Chaos has three workers left and Ling Ling's has 33. So now he's got a few army units, can send them across the map. Ling Ling's hasn't really rebuilt his army just yet. He's chrono boosting out a Colossi and has a couple stalkers. But there's now four Marines that have come up here and are attacking the Nexus.
Oh no, and two stalkers. Oh man, I feel like... Oh my god, I feel like I'm watching like League of Legends or something here. Like, just a couple of... It's like dudes on dudes, you know?
Yep. Well, these two Marines were...
Oh my god!
Interesting rally point, actually.
I will eat my shoe if Crazy Chaos loses his command center to a mothership core.
The thing is, dude, I don't know if you should promise that. Yeah.
Oh.
Okay.
No.
You might want to take that back. Shoes aren't particularly good for you. Meanwhile,
I like to take
this
the
Widow Mine, this Widow Mine almost kills the mothership core. We've seen. I don't think he realized what happened because he just looks over and is like, "Oh, nothing's attacking it now." No, wrong ship. Oh, dies.
Oh, snap.
But the Protoss has reloaded his army, and he's going out with a bunch with the boys, two stalkers, and a Colossi. Oh, they're gonna fight in this choke point, which is gonna be super good for the Protoss Colossi here, which is just gonna kill so many units.
It's like feeding wood into a chipper, man.
Oh man.
Oh, this is delicious.
Turns out Colossi is really, really good against small numbers of units just because of the health bar it has.
Yeah, pretty much, dude. Like... Oh, man. Well...
He doesn't care about that. He's like, nope, I'm gonna preserve that.
Look at the SUV. Oh my god, the SUV was just like, no! No!
Oh, is the splash damage not gonna kill the wood of mine? Nope, not yet.
Oh, that would be awesome. That would be awesome if it did. Like, it's just one of those like things that look awesome, but like you just didn't know you did it. You know, it's like when you mash buttons when you're playing a fighting game and like you don't know what the special move commands are, and then suddenly you just do this like Metsu Hadouken, like
yeah, you pull like, off a suit, thing, you pull off an ultra with Ryu, and you're like, I can't replicate that, but that was cool.
Is that
he loaded up the worker and he's taking off.
Oh my god. Bye!
Bye! Well, okay. There's a Widowmine still there. I don't really know what our Terran friend can do in this situation. This is a best of five.
Himself.
He's probably going for a fatigue strategy. He wants to make his opponent tired for the next game. He'll just plop his command center down,
snap.
go get a drink of water, and relax for a bit while his opponent's like.
Stalkers, man. he chose to float over land where he can be chased, as opposed to the gold base where it's like. It's like you need a warp prism to get here,
unless you have a plan, you really should not do this.
It's awesome, man. I do this all the time, dude. It's pretty awesome. It doesn't work, but
do you do it when you don't have an option left?
I do it when I'm shit faced.
Okay. You do it when you're drunk. Alright, makes sense.
Yeah.
By the way, that widow mine. This one widow mine has six kills. Against Protoss.
No,
that's
the GG. Okay.
That's the GG. Yep. I guess he was thinking maybe he can get the factory away and produce a couple widow mines. Maybe just do something with that. He had a plan.
Yeah.
There was a plan there.
Well, it was okay. I said it was okay. You'll be awesome, though. Like, if you had like two goats and you had two nukes, and then you set the nukes off like at the same time. That'd be awesome, cause like, you know, cause like if Cena finds out one of the goats and like kills him off, then it's just gonna be like, oh, I got a ghost. There's no nukes.
Yeah, that's
just
right.
Look back at the main. It's like, oh shit! I just lost all my probes.
So, we're looking at 1-1 right now. Crazy Chaos and Leaf Cena both having picked up one game apiece. This is a best of five once again, so we're not at match point just yet.
Oh, man. I want to see Aura Swap play. That would be a dream come true. I want to see my bro play, man. Where is she? It says, eat your shoe. Dude, I gotta say, like, that doesn't happen.
Nah, it's expensive. Like, don't eat your shoe.
Oh man, I'm tempted to just like, take a picture of me with like a plate and a knife and a fork, and there's like a shoe in the middle of it, and just post it on Twitter, like.
Or draw a like cartoon version of yourself eating a shoe.
Oh,
but I would think that's cool.
Oh yeah, you just want to see my art skills, don't you?
Oh yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. I can't do that. Maybe I can. I mean, I used to be an artist, so it's all good, man.
Oh, looks like we're moving on to Dusk Towers next.
Dust Towers. Oh man, the droppy map. The map of drops. I
Just
do like
beautiful
this.
airspace on the
I
Gold
know, right?
Island base.
Yeah, I know, right? It's like, dude, if your air attack fails, just retreat to the gold and you'll be totally fine. You can't reach him, man. Good luck, heaven. Alright. Well, would you like to start us off?
Sure. Top of the map, we have tied with his opponent. It is our Terran teal player. Crazy Chaos.
Terran. Once again, Terran. Yes. Alright. Well, at the bottom, pink. Pink. Many pink. It is the pink Primrose. DJ Ling Lings. Ah, yeah. Looks like Crazy Chaos is gonna do something. Well, he's obviously up to something. I mean, he's getting the double guess this time, without a barracks this early on in the game, so you know something's up.
Yeah.
It's.
Double.
I don't think. Yeah, like, I don't think it's gonna get an expansion on the back of this. Like, it'll be
No.
really weird if he did, because you
I
just
mean,
wouldn't have.
he just
Yeah,
wouldn't
you
really
wouldn't
be
have.
able to use it for a long time if he did that.
Yeah, you just get like an excess amount of gas, and it's like, well, what do I do? I guess I can get two ravens out at a time at the 6 minute mark or something.
Ling's, on the other hand, is also grabbing two gases. He's actually getting his second gas slightly before the cybernetic score. Which, I mean,
Yeah.
it's the slightly modified timing doesn't really indicate anything specifically, though.
Yeah, it does have 500, well, 400 mils. I mean,
Whoa.
like, this is enough
Okay,
for an expansion.
that's a
Oh.
little there. Yeah, cancel that. You're gonna end up really messing up your gas income if you put that there.
Oh no. Don't do that. It hurts. It hurts real
See, the
bad.
good thing though is that he canceled it, he realized it right away, moved it somewhere else. I have a feeling I would have just left it there and then looked later and been like, oh, that's silly. And then just been like, whatever.
You don't want to cancel it because of your pride, man.
I just
Well,
wouldn't have
I'm
noticed. I would have
putting
been looking at something else.
it. It'll be funny, like, if like you placed that like completely the wrong position, and then you just leave it there, and then you're just like, well, actually, no, that was intentional. Actually,
I
it
have.
was a strategic decision to stop the movement of Reapers.
I do have, like,
Shit.
one. I have had that kind of happen, though, where, like, I'll put down the Nexus one line of squares off, and I'm like, I'm not fixing that. That's 100 minerals, whatever. Even though technically you lose so much more than that problem.
Pride, man, pride.
Yep, that's kind of
You
more
don't
just
want
like, eh, whatever.
you don't want to be wrong.
Nope. But Starport coming out, this isn't too terribly surprising. I mean, it kind of does make sense that one of the principal things you see people go for with double gas is Banshee a lot of the time. But we're not seeing
Barracks.
the add-ons being thrown down by the factory, so it's gonna
Yeah,
take a
this
little
is
time
just.
for it to get to that.
Yeah, straight up just naked 111, dude. Like, this is good. I mean, it did get an expansion on the back of all this, so you know he's gonna be steady heady, so you know he
Uh-oh.
will have an army and you know something to fall back on
Triple
if this doesn't work.
Marine! Goodbye, Triple
And
Marine!
it's.
Oh, nope, he's gonna go home.
I like how the stalker just like hang back. It's like you know how in anime like if it's like a 2v1, like one of the like bad guys is just gonna be like, oh well, I'll let you handle this one. Go 1v1 it.
Yeah, I mean, if it's like martial arts style anime or Dragon Ball.
Yeah,
And
or if
then,
it's some stupid yeah
thankfully, a
some.
lot of other series since then have abandoned that because it is a little silly.
It's like,
But.
dude, it's 2v1, just fucking kill him, man! It's just right in front of, it's right in front of you.
Right?
No, actually no. Just
Okay.
I want you to 1v1 him because I want you to show me how much you've progressed
Oh
in your
no.
training.
I was wrong. He is getting a Banshee, but he's also getting a Fusion Core, which means he's
Yeah.
probably going up to Battle Cruisers.
Oh, he could be going for
Or
the
Banshee
movement speed
Speed.
upgrade of
Yeah.
the Banshees, which is not really talked about that much. It's super underrated. Like, if you get that upgrade, like it's pretty good.
It's
It's
good.
really
You can
good.
kind of think of it as it gives you like really late game cloaking oracles,
Yeah.
basically, in terms
Oh.
of how fast they move.
Yeah, actually, that's true, because if a Protoss sees you going for that, maybe they'll go for, like, Phoenixes and stuff, but, like, the thing is, like if Banshees have, like, the same movement speed as Phoenixes, like, you know, they can just get out.
I'll be honest, I think most Protoss players don't have a plan for that, because it requires a really strange set of circumstances to end up in that position, where that's even a good idea.
Oh, like the Banshee speed upgrade?
Or even where it happens and it's a threat. A lot of the time you're going to have anti-air, or maybe you already have high Templar that you can feed back them. It's not that bad. Yeah. But there are cases. It's definitely possible to get to that point and just kind of cause havoc.
Yeah, pretty much.
Alright, so Cloak's about to finish.
Let's see how much value this gets. 100 energy Banshee on the move, and it's just going to move that. Oh, what the?
cloaked.
And then
okay.
Uncloaked. Yeah.
Well, better than staying cloaked for the entire ride and then not having any energy when you get there.
Yeah, that's true.
I like this. Leaf Cena's going for a Fleet Beak, and both players doing a little cheeky things on two base.
Oh, my goodness. It looks like. Oh, look at that. Look what's coming out of the starboard. It is indeed a battlecruiser,
But the cruiser is operational. Unfortunately, his opponent's going for Void Rays. Void Rays, the counter to everything cool. Anyway, we have a Cloak Banshee now in position attacking a pylon, surprisingly. A double Fleet Beacon?
It wants those upgrades. Faster.
Really badly. By the way, the arm units are here, so they are sacrificing themselves to the Banshee.
Oh my god.
Nope, now they're realizing they don't have the ability to shoot at the thing that's cloaked, so they're leaving.
the funniest thing is nothing died.
Nope, the Banshee's like, you know what? I'm gonna kill your stuff.
For the boys!
Wait, yeah, is Leaf Cena just kind of going for it? Oh, by the way, there's two aliens just showed up. Oh no.
Oh my god, yeah, like...
He should actually just run the Hellions in
there. Yeah, that's gonna have a hot ass, man.
Here comes the Terran units. Oh no, this is gonna turn into a weird really weird base race.
Hi, Steve.
He's pulling all the boys as well. What is this game?
Oh my goodness. Yeah, he's just going to...
Okay, the Protoss has retreated into the top left corner with all of his workers. Meanwhile, all of the workers of the Terran, because he's like, I want to join in on this. He's sending him across the map to attack the Protoss.
Oh my god, is this a base race? A couple of Void Rays coming in.
Is this a base race? I'm not sure what this is. But he's attacking the rocks up here at the gold base of the Terran.
Keeping them occupied, man. This is like throwing a dog a toy just to keep him busy, you know?
He's gonna lose those. yeah, that would be... this one? Oh, here comes his stuff's coming back. All the workers of the Terran have found the workers of the Protoss and are now killing them out in the middle of the map. They're trying to. They killed one. They killed two. All right, good job, guys. Good job.
Oh, no. Well, in the meantime...
Oh, there's a siege tank up there.
Just much.
He's blowing up his own SCV. Nope, okay.
Oh my goodness.
Exploded. And that's the end of the Void Ray.
Meanwhile, another battle cruiser incoming.
This could have been a base race.
Yeah,
it's not a base race.
It's basically It's just destruction, man. It's just chaos.
I think these four Void Rays can win this fight unless there's a micro error that happens here. Yeah, because they're gonna kill the Marines off pretty quick. There's no repair, and the battle cruiser is just gonna die. Much damage. The cybernetics core is gone, the Nexus is gone, the two fleet beacons are gone, half the pylons are dead now.
The SCVs, oh god, the SCVs are joining them in the fight. Well, I think they're just there to prepare the...
This I don't like. This was funny the first time, Chaos, is you probably want to keep these at home at this point, because now all you've got battle cruiser that's not going to have any repairs.
Oh my god! Hi.
Two ships passing in the night. No, okay, he's gonna stop and turn and shoot. No, don't. Okay, well, at least they'll both have an economy of zero.
Is this how it's going to end?
Yes, it is.
Oh, this tragedy.
Oh my goodness. Is this the funny thing you were talking about, Leafs the United? I think it was.
Oh, shit.
Where you were like, Man, this is one of the weirdest games I've ever seen.
Oh my god, well, you see that. I mean, yeah, he has a game-winning army right here, dude. Like,
but the important thing is that Crazy Chaos realized that he could send his workers back home. So.
Oh, that's well, that's unfortunate. Yeah.
Yeah.
That's kind of unfortunate. That's gonna have money to buy
so
things.
So Leaf Sina has five workers, one of which is not working. Scumbag. Or he's traumatized. I don't know.
Yeah. Well, meanwhile, Leaf Sina is just going around just to try and, you know, just to try and catch Crazy Chaos off guard with a sudden Void Ray attack. I mean, you could just obliterate everything. Like straight in like a straight up fight, and you know it could still win. Yeah. But no,
couple of Widow Mines, spread them out in the base, pretty much shuts this down.
Yep, but
he's building Hellions.
Yeah, I feel like there's a generally cooler.
I mean, they are cooler. Dude. I'll give you that. I mean, they're cars with flamethrowers on them. I mean, you can't. That's pretty awesome.
They're doom buggies with flamethrowers, dude. How cool is that? Yeah. Uh-oh. Oh, here come the Void Rays. Oh,
Void Rays.
Have an army.
Void Rays use their intimidation tactics against the Marines.
Well,
they,
it's...
They let their spines out, so to speak.
Yeah. Well, looks like another battlecruiser is going to sacrifice its life to the Void Rays if it ever comes. And this is.
Well, I mean, he's got enough workers that he can kind of just kind of fix it.
Yeah. Oh, pull the boys. SCP's versus Void Rays.
No, this you probably know.
Go, round two. Let's do this.
He is actually buying some time here. He's just got to run the. He's just got to grab this battlecruiser and run north.
Oh, you want to bet? He's
not
just going to sacrifice it. I want to bet.
Oh, no.
He's just going to sacrifice it.
Does he have the energy for a Yamato when it comes out?
Nah, he doesn't.
Okay. He's on a move command! And there's Marines now! He's going to kill the Void Ray! Yeah! He's actually tanking really well for the Marines here. Oh, he switched targets. Oh, no!
Alright,
I think he's going to hold.
At
the very least, he should be able to buy time. There's only one Void Ray left.
Micro! Oh, there's two Marines! Oh, no, he left no one alive! Oh, that's a huge difference in DPS. Yeah. The difference between, like, three Marines and have two Marines is, like...
There's also a single Hellion inside Leaf Sina's base now.
Oh, my goodness.
He's gonna set the one probe that wasn't doing any work on fire. Not killing
him.
Here comes a Void Ray.
Void Rays, man. So, oh my god.
I don't really know.
Oh my god! The pylon! Oh no! Don't get the
pylon! Of course he's gonna rebuild it, but it's like. Admittedly, he needs. Like, if he gets those two more Void Rays out, this is kind of. This is actually looking really bad for
Oh god.
I mean, really bad for Crazy Chaos. Leaf Sina has this massive bank. If he could actually rebuild his production structures, he would totally be able to build an army out of nowhere. But he's committing. He's committed to Void Rays.
Oh
my
god.
Run over a bunch of Marines that just turn and start to shoot. Well, the Marines are gonna shoot back. It turns out that spaceships in space beat dudes with rifles on the ground. Usually this is true. Not always, though.
Yeah, in this game, it's very important to preserve the balance. You have an imbalanced unit versus an imbalanced unit.
That's right. It's
so
important that the battlecruisers come very low into the atmosphere so the Marines have the chance to shoot them. That's pretty much my go-to argument whenever someone's like, to be honest, this thing should be taken out of the game because it's ridiculous. I'm like, nope, that's not important. It's just not important.
Wait, the battlecruiser?
Cool.
No,
coolness is what's important. In design, right. Funness is important. Sense? No. Not in an RTS. You kidding? No. Nobody wants to have that game where the Borg cube kills everything. Star Trek Armada. But
you mean it's good to have a unit that's just for fun, but like isn't really practical? Oh, snap.
Oh, yeah. That's good, too, but for other reasons. So, okay, we have the Marine Sacrifice going in there, almost getting one Void Ray, and we're going to have a repeat of about 5 minutes ago, where four Void Rays are going to come in and try and kill the Terran. Kind of trying to stutter stuff here, some Marines, let's kill them all as they come out. Here comes the SCVs again.
And from and that day onwards, that Void Ray...
Oh no, there's more!
Oh, both of them got away!
Oh, snap.
Oh, he's gonna lift up the buildings now.
Retreat!
Oh my gosh, what is this game?
Well, in the meantime...
This is an amazing game. This is a work of art. I think the Protoss won, though.
Oh yeah, no, absolutely, dude. Like, what would four SCVs do versus, versus things that shoot down? And they can't shoot up. SCVs can't shoot up, spoiler alert.
You note that he has them on attack command right now, which is the only reason they're actually flipping immediately to shoot the Marines that get spawned. Kind of learning something with that, by the way. Not really good to focus target above buildings. You're just camping in production. Oh, there goes the production, though. And that bonus, the SCVs are not able to cancel the production with Void Rays this time.
Aw, this is so sad. This is just a sad story.
Oh, SCVs going for the escape. Void Rays coming in for the pursuit.
The story of how a couple of SCVs valiantly sacrificed their lives for the greater good of mankind.
Yep. There is no army left. These 11 workers that you see. It's actually not all of them. There's a couple of them back over at this gold base. But most of these workers, they are the last of the human race. And they're going on a bold, valiant mission into the heart of alien territory. Oh, they've been discovered. Laser beams come down.
Two of them have died. Have confirmed that this place
the early
is
sacrifice
a death
has occurred. Unfortunately, none of them was, I guess.
Oh, they got
there was no action superheroes. That was the squad that they left a record at the base, and then when the actual heroes showed up later and they discovered the base and they just explored this ruined thing, this like ruined structure, they find this journal, and they found it about Suicide Squad workers.
It's like Rogue Legacy, dude. Like
pretty much. Like this is the setup to Rogue Legacy.
Yeah. our father ventured into this castle of nothing but death traps. I wonder what could be inside. Let's find out. Maybe there could be some treasure that I can leave for my children.
It's basically that game is basically Lemmings the Metroid game. If you think about it, how many people do you sacrifice trying to get to the end of that game? Like 100?
You just committed genocide.
Admittedly, by the way, after beating that game, going back, I found it really hard to play. Like, I just wasn't as into it. Oh, Void Race have discovered the outpost.
Oh, snap.
So now the last bastion of humanity, unfortunately, they didn't get into the transport ship in time. They are going to die. Looks like this. We're not gonna get away.
Seconds.
It's not. We're not gonna have Battlestar Galactica. Nope. Okay.
Damn, that Cece just died in seconds, man. Oh yeah. And GG. And GG is cool.
Game three.
Oh,
game three. Going to leave Cena. Puts him ahead 2-1 in the series. He is now in position to win the whole thing if he can win just one more of the two remaining games.
Yep, this is a chance for Crazy Chaos to claw back into the fray and make it 2-2 to make it a match point, match game, game point, game point, game point, game point.
Match point is when you're about to win in tennis, and then, yeah. Match point is like the whole match, not...
I forgot what they're called,
And then you have set point for when you're about to win a set. Game point when you're about to win a game.
Oh, yeah.
For those of you that don't know, tennis is scored by games represent points won in the base unit of tennis scoring. And then you win a certain number of games and you win a set. And then you win 2 out of 3 sets and you win the match. Usually.
Oh, I remember. Yeah, I remember the scoring is really weird.
It is weird.
It's you score once against 15 numbering. Points.
Love 15, 30, 40. Deuce.
Advantage. 20. Oh, I can't stop. Yeah, I can't stop taking the piss out of like the French numbering system. It's like how to count from 1 to 100 in French. Is, you know, like count the tens, right? That's 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 60, 10. I didn't say 70, they say 60, 10, and it's like 60. They say 60, 20 for 80, I think, and then like for 90, they get 60, 20, 10.
That is weird. Well, I mean, no offense if you're into that language or anything, but that would probably confuse me a bit. I mean, it's all reflexes at the end of the day, right? Like, so it's nothing, but
it's just really, yeah, it's just one of those like really weird things. Like,
oh, this game's a PVT as well, man.
Uh-oh. Oh, man. Oh, bloody hell. He is really hammering on the turret, man. He just doesn't want to play Zerg.
Yeah, maybe he's just, like, random Protoss Terran, not, like, no Zerg. Flips a coin.
That's funny. In any I play random, but I play Protoss and Terran. You're fake. You're a fake!
In any case, we should probably get started. So let's dive into game number 4 here.
Oh, okay. But Zero needs to empty his bladder, man.
Oh, I did not realize he left. My bad.
Yeah.
It's all good. We'll just keep talking then.
Zero is now a human waterfall.
So let's see here. I have on my desk a menu to a Japanese restaurant.
Ah.
That just opened up in the area that I'm thinking about going to sometime this week.
Oh, sweet. But, like, yeah. I have a feeling it's going to be really expensive because, like, when... Like, if it's... Basically, if it's exotic, then, like, they have a reason to drive the prices up, you know? Like...
Yeah, I mean, it's not that bad. They have... Well, it depends on what you want to order. Ooh. Like, there's some things in here that I know are, like, more authentic, and ironically, they're usually the cheaper things. I'm not going to buy sushi. I don't really get sushi in the U.S. if I can help it. But,
Like,
there's a few different things in here that look alright. But you have, like, the hibachi steak stuff that's really kind of expensive. But it's just because it's steak, you know?
Yeah, like...
Oh, man, the sushi is like, kind of... Wow, that is actually kind of overpriced. Well, sushi aside, the soups are pretty fun. The soups are fine. They have, like, some not a chicken dishes that look pretty good.
Oh yeah. I have a feeling like if like there's a lot of them in the area, then I don't think it's gonna be expensive. I'm not sure if there are like a lot of them in the US though. Like
there is one other. Well, there's a few Japanese restaurants in this area. They don't have a lot of Japanese food that I like, unfortunately. But they exist. Like I really like Japanese curry. That's next to impossible to find here.
Japanese curry.
Thai curry is everywhere.
Yeah, it's like Japanese curry. Like, what is that? I don't even know what that is.
I mean, it's like it's a stir fry with a set of curry spices served next to rice, but like the curry sauce isn't as spicy as what you would find in like India or even probably Korea.
I probably wouldn't like that.
But it's like it is. It's got a nice spicy edge to it, but it's pretty mild still. It's a good time.
Yeah. Yeah, I just don't like my curry mild. Like it. So I want it hot, man. I want my curry like so hot that like I can't talk the next day. I'm not even kidding, dude. Like, go big or go home, right?
Wait, that happens? You're like,
I used to snack on chili peppers.
Oh my.
Now, yeah, I think that explains everything, right?
Well, it explains some things. It doesn't explain why you can still talk, but it does explain some other things. Nah, I'm joking. But in all seriousness, it is actually
Leaf Cena says this is less than bronze versus less than bronze. I wouldn't say that.
No, I think you guys are maybe upper bronze level. You're getting to silver, you're not that far away.
Yeah. I mean I know how bronze people play. Like I mean, yeah, that's basically bronze, like, kind of. Garfang says, I walked away for a bit. Why are they still alive, man? Oh god, you remember that? Do you remember that game between Liz and Loopy? And like it was on Dusk Towers, but like there was no gas. Like the map was glitched, so like they had to kill each other using only minerals. So Loopy just built like a bajillion cannons like everywhere, and like Liz just built like marines, and like the match went on for like, I think it went on for like an hour or something, and it came back and it was like, hell man, just end it already, man. Oh man, where's Loopy? Actually, no, Loopy's gone to bed. Where's Liz?
I guess we should probably get started now.
Yes.
If we can.
Yes. It's getting late.
Game
yes.
4, PVT. It's almost 10 o'clock over at...
Oh, over it's on the Purify map.
Banban World.
Oh,
Central
I need to go to...
Protocol.
Shit.
This map is weird.
Oh, this map.
This map, man.
Yeah, the number of times... Like, the number of times you get fucked over, like, because you didn't pay attention to, like, the back of your base. It's like, oh, okay, well, I'm just going to macro it up with, like, a supply depot and a barracks, and I make a nice little wolf. Oh, what's that? Oh, how did you... Right.
So why don't you go ahead and start this one off for us?
Alrighty. Well, yeah, in the bottom right. Actually, no, I gotta go bottom left first, because I haven't introduced this guy yet. On the bottom left is the Blue Terran. It is the ever so chaotic. It is crazy chaos. Sea Rage.
And in the bottom right side of the map, we have his opponent from Clan DJ. It is Ling Ling's. Clan DJ, by the way, has a bunch of other people that play in this. Mother Moose and Luka Doo in particular.
Yeah.
Played yesterday.
Where's Muffin? Where's Muffin?
He's off being covert, I assume. But yeah, there's like a bunch of other tiny things about this map. You notice that the mineral patches are actually uniquely designed on this tile set. They look smaller.
They look like rupees.
The gas geysers technically look the same once the building's over them, but when they're on the ground, they look a little bit different. Here, your choke point into your main is not a ramp. But it is also a ramp, but it has these rocks on it, so you have a double entrance natural. And your natural has a huge ramp on it. So this is definitely a map where I think they were trying to encourage you to go for some cheeky fast stuff. Because it looks like defending bases here is just kind of hard in general. There are two gold bases in the center that you never see anyone take, but they're there. You can spawn in any one of these four locations, and if you spawn close by ground, the attack distance is pretty small.
oh, if you break the rocks and stuff? Yeah, no, stuff gets chaotic.
No, I mean, like, here. I don't know if I can actually ping in this spot. See this spot?
Yeah.
If this guy spawns at the top of the map on the left side, that's how much distance you have to go to get to his natural.
Oh yeah, that as well, yeah, that as
if
well.
That happens to you, and the other guy just happened to be rushing Lings, well, you're dead. I mean, there's no, you're dead.
Yeah, it's a really funky map, actually. That's kind of why, like, I either, like, wall off, like, at the front, like, just at the front, or just, you know, I just wall off at the big, like, if I'm going for, like, a fast expansion, I just wall off at the big ramp and, just basically hope.
Yeah, I mean, the thing is, at the same time, the other person, of course, is making a gamble if they go for that. They happen to be, like, close by air, and they have to go the entire way around the map, and, you know, they can be kind of screwed over by that strategy. So, it's just one of those maps.
It's awesome. I like this map. I mean, I like
but
the design.
But it's so pretty.
Shiny.
It's gorgeous. I hope they use this tile set again.
I know, right? Oh, man, it's just... Yes. Well, it looks like both players haven't actually found each other yet, so they're just building whatever they want, but they're doing all this blind without, you know, any idea where the other guy is, so, yep. You know. Yeah, just zero scouting, man. That's how it's done. That's how it's done. Now,
doing the, we're going to shoot first, ask questions later form of defense. Just stay in the front. There's no need to send delegates to the enemy. No need to set up trade agreements.
Just, you know, yeah, it's like playing, you know, I feel like this is like playing Age of Empires. You know, it's just...
Pretty much.
You just sit there with a bunch of dudes and you just gather food up until 500 and then you just go up an agent, like, that's just how it's done.
Yep. Gotta rush for those higher tech units.
Oh, yeah, oh, there's trebuchets.
Trebuchets, get your little army of knights.
How do you turn this on?
Kill all of his workers and run away.
Pretty much. Oh, man. Anyone else in the chat know any other cheat codes? Like...
Actually, never messed with the cheat codes in that game. There were a bunch of typed in ones.
Yeah, the typed in ones. Like, if you type in how do you turn this on, you get like a car that has like insane DPS and it's just like the fastest thing ever.
That's awesome.
I think it has like something like 500 DPS, like something huge. It just kills everything in its way, basically.
I remember there was like an expansion for that for Age of Empires 2 that was like all Star Wars themed.
Oh shit! I didn't even see that. No.
I really vaguely remember this. It was pretty fun from what I recall, but the only reason why I think I'm having trouble recalling it is I believe somebody else I knew owned this and I borrowed it. So it's just one of those things where I just kind of never saw it again growing up, so...
Oh, yeah. That's
it's not sad. Like I picked up a box and moved it around or anything, so, you know.
Oh, I remember that, yeah. Like, God, I don't like rent games, man. Just, I want them. I want it for myself.
Yeah, you did what you had to do.
Okay, so it is the 6-minute mark, and Cena is going for a third Nexus.
Yep.
Vigistalkers.
He's gone for the Nexus that makes sense given these positions, despite the fact that he still doesn't know where his opponent is.
Neither. They haven't scouted each other yet. Oh,
well,
this is brilliant.
Here comes the move out. It's the patented scout with your army tactic. Nope, never mind. He's changing his mind. He's going to go back up the ramp. It's scary out there. Gotta stay home.
It's dangerous to go alone. Take the siege tank.
It's dangerous to go alone. We need medevacs.
It's dangerous to go alone. Take this. Oh, thanks, old man. That's really, really nice. Like,
Have you heard that? Three more gateways in blink. So I think it's pretty obvious what Leaf Sina wants to do. Just needs to find his enemy, and he's gonna attack him with a bunch of blink stalkers. Very straightforward.
Yeah, look at that. Like, dude, like 6 gateways. Blink, and forge.
Yeah, and he's got a good worker economy to back this up. Crazy Chaos, on the other hand, still a little bit behind on workers, but he has a really nice sized army.
He needs to go find
his enemy and attack. I think he's actually got. Yeah, there's two pylons here for defense.
Oh my goodness! Yeah, here we go.
He could lose this third for free. And
yeah,
his defense is oriented at the front of the natural. There's nothing back here at the rocks.
Yeah, I don't think 10 Stalkers is going to cut it for Cena right here. No. And his army is going to get hit in 3,
oh, 2, man, he guessed correctly.
1.
He must have figured it
goodness.
Out from some... From
map
something.
Hacks! Map hacks! I call map hacks!
Okay, so no map siege up here, unfortunately. There it goes. Now he's going to bring that up here. He do have a photon overcharge. Mothership falls, so no more photon overcharge. And yeah, he just has too much DPS. I think he just kills everything.
Oh my god, Stalkers are just not good against Marines. You could potentially have got put down to, you know. Oh, no,
GG.
That's GG.
Yep, that happens.
No, that's
part of that just comes down to he guessed the right location, though.
Oh, yeah.
If he went to the other two bases, he might have had enough time. Oh, well.
Oh, yeah, maybe, yeah.
Because, like, he didn't have blink, I don't think. So, if that... Yeah, if he had blink, he might have had a better shot there.
Yeah, pretty much. So, yeah, like... I mean, yeah, he had, like, 7... like 7 warp gates, something like that. So, yeah. I mean, those were scary amounts of marines, so... I mean, even if you got, 14 extra stalkers or something like that, I don't know, but I think... I'm not sure if he would break through mass marines and tanks, both of which killed stalkers really fast. super fast, man. It just melt.
But yeah, you know, I like the photon overcharges. If you could have thrown in a little time warp bubble as well, moved his units back so that the Terran had to start walking through this slow warp field and get some extra shots in there. So there's ways to take that exact situation that Leaf Sino was in, just refine it a little bit, maybe hold out. So it's difficult for me to say, though, because obviously, of course, there's improvements that could be made on the other side as well, though I really liked, for the most part, what Crazy Chaos did there. Getting the Mothership Core and then put down pylons real quick before they could cause any issues.
God. You want to bet it was map hacking, though? Map hackers are a problem on the ladder nowadays. It's ridiculous.
Yeah, okay, Zeno's helping me out live. With the name, by the way. That's Galactic Battlegrounds, apparently, was the name of the expansion, Star Wars themed expansion that I was thinking of.
The best ever!
It was fun.
I think I remember that, just a little bit.
A very interesting game. Anyway, we're now on to game number 5, Ruins of Saris. On the left side of the map, we have his opponent, once again tied. It is our Terran player, Crazy Chaos. Into pink.
Yep. And in the right side, having switched colors, Ling Ling's Leaf Sina is now the blue Protoss. On Ruins of Saris, the 4-player map.
So this map is really big. Really big.
Yeah, they actually spawned on almost opposite sides. They didn't spawn on opposite corners. I mean, the distance between the two bases is actually kind of large. So, yeah, looks like it's gonna be, I'm not sure. Wait, Crazy Chaos. Crazy Chaos, what is this? What are you doing?
Supply depots?
Well, looks like he's, he has supply block of phobia, I think.
Eh, whatever, I guess, right? Meanwhile, his opponent is doing the same thing he's done every single game, so...
It's strange. It's really weird.
Gateway, guess.
It's kind of bizarre how Crazy Chaos has been playing basically, great up until this point. This is the last game of the best of 5, and then he...
He's scouting. He's like, I'm not having that problem ever again. I'm gonna find out where you live.
Oh snap. Early scout, oh snap. Gateway, Cybercore. Very solid opening versus the Terran. It's just gonna get it's gonna get 2 gases and
triple
probably
barracks.
A Stargate.
Quad
yep.
barracks.
Oh, 3 barracks.
4 barracks.
1 barracks.
So I guess he's
2 barracks.
And he's got these did he have these rallies somewhere? For a second I think he did.
Which ones? Oh, the probe?
No, yeah, I thought Crazy Chaos had his stuff rallied somewhere. But it doesn't look like he did. I was imagining things. He's got the... He actually does not really need too many add-ons if he's going to go all the way up to 4 on one base. Really should just pump these out and walk, find his opponent, send a SUV scout out there. Figure out where he is and just send those marines across the map.
Oh yeah, oh god, barracks, and oh my god, marines. Reactor coming up, and out of that barracks is gonna come out marine.
There's basically zero defenses at the Protoss base right now. It's gonna be a mothership core in a second, but there's no pylons in the low ground. You can actually pick off this natural really easily.
Yep. He needs some pylons right now, otherwise he's just gonna get overwhelmed by a billion, bazillion marines.
Probe's walking up here. Oh, he's found out there's a barracks and he sees 2 more. I think the jig is up.
Yep, and here comes the panic building of basically anything.
Might not have been watching, unfortunately.
it did see quite a lot of barracks.
He's getting the forge and pylon. Okay.
Forge
he's gonna
put
some cannons, maybe.
Yeah. The cannons, yeah, like one or two cannons just to kind of defend the low ground a little bit. Like, yeah, like if you do that, you're basically in a pretty solid position.
There's so many Marines. He's already at 14.
Oh my goodness. Oh, and nothing boy. But Marines, man. It's just, you know, it's just. That's how it's done. That's how it's done. Well, it looks like this supply depot that we built early on really helped unsupply block him.
I guess he's going to expand while he attacks?
Uh oh. Oh, that. That will be more Marines.
Uh-oh.
You did queue up more Marines. What's the plan? What's the plan? There's an SCV right there.
I think he wanted to build a base, and then he decided to keep his Marine production going.
Uh-oh. Oh snap. Money management. Oh snap. Cancels the Marine. Okay, built him. Okay.
It's fine.
Okay, no point.
It's not really a problem. He's just exchanging his mana or whatever. Really should attack, though. Really, really should attack with his army. Should at least find out where his opponent is, if nothing else.
Oh snap! Well, this is a race against time, man. I mean, you know, Zine is just getting more and more well prepared for this kind of stuff. I mean, this is a scary amount of Marines. Granted,
he kind of is. There's still no defenses in the natural at all.
Yeah, like losing that base is just gonna suck.
If it happens. I think.
Yeah.
I have, you know what? I bet you he's not attacking.
Oh.
I think
it's the
World
War standoff. It is the God of World War standoff strategy again. Queuing up Marines all day, every day.
Now, I feel like this is the kind of thing you do when you're trying to hard blind counter a cheese of some kind.
Oh, just like get a bunch of Marines.
Have an army bigger than his army that he could be attacking you with. But then the army doesn't show up, and you're like, oh, what do I do? I guess I just have a lot of Marines.
I guess I can just kill him. Maybe. Alright, well. Let's see. Well, we do have the triple robo from Cena. That'll let him get him all.
Nuke.
Why?
Getting the nuke.
Oh, snappity.
You know what? He's going for style points. That's what it is. It's not about victory. He got the Marines early on just to make sure he wouldn't die really quickly. Now he's going for nukes. This is the plan. Victory is achieving hitting his base with nukes, most likely.
Oh, snap. Here it is. Ghost coming out right now. Oh, snap. He's just getting the pick and mix army of basically everything. Marines, Hellions, like, whatever, man. Just have something.
Yeah, I think there was some confusion in the chat before about nukes. You can build one nuke per ghost academy, so you can build multiple ghost academies and have multiple nukes to shoot. That way. You can also rebuild the nuke after it's been fired. So you can definitely have multiple nukes in one game. Alright.
Yeah.
Scout with the whole army technique. Here we go.
Yeah, it's pretty uncommon to see like multiple ghost academies because, you know, obviously it's minerals invested in something. But investing in minerals is something you don't want to do lightly because there's a minerals, man. Money. Don't throw money, do you? Don't throw money to
the river. He's lucky that the marine ball is going entirely in the wrong direction on the scout path. Because Ling Ling's was basically supply blocked and stuck down there at
Oh my god.
Oh, he's building triple colossi.
Triple colossi, here we go.
They may have had their damage nerfed, but these are unupgraded Marines. They will still obliterate them.
Oh my god, let's see. It still has about 30 seconds. The Marine's gonna get there sometime soon.
He might still lose the natural, but I think he's gonna have enough to hold.
Yeah, the colossi are just gonna do it, man. I don't think the Marines are actually gonna get there in time. Yeah, it's just gonna have free colossi, like.
Okay, some Marines are gonna fight for free. Sacrifice themselves before the ball gets here. And then here comes the giant ball of Marines.
Oh my god!
Oh, Colossus are out in the field. Two Colossus are out. Three Colossus now out on the field. Three Colossus are not feeling like participating in the battle. Here they come, though. And.
Don't lose the Colossi, don't mark it! Oh, no!
Kind of a little anti-micro, but he is going to win this fight, I think, just barely.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Unfortunately, there's more Marines. And a cloaked dude. Oh, but he has an Observer! Nuke coming down. Oh, no! He's gonna kill the nuke! No.
Oh, man. Well, that's a bad kill.
So, hey. It turns out Marines streaming from the other side of the map do die in a single Colossus.
See that, Mike? Oh my god, 44 hit points, 44 hit points, Colossus.
44 hit point Colossus that has 24 kills.
Oh my god.
And he's got a friend now.
It's gonna come, the Marine's gonna come, and I'm right. Lols. Oh my goodness.
So, why did the upgrades that I mentioned before actually matter? If you have combat shields, you have 10 more health. They do 20 damage, I think, per laser beam.
26, yeah.
They go from having... They were nerfed. I don't think it's 26.
It's 30. Oh, sorry. It's 12. It's 24. But Cena actually has plus one upgrades, so that's 26 now. So.
Okay. Yeah. Anyway, their health bar is 45 normally. So with 10 more HP, they actually take 3 shots to die. That would have caused them to win the fight, actually.
Yes.
Pretty simply enough. But still, I mean, okay, we got another attempt here. We got another ghost coming up. He's thinking about going out there, but he knows there's detection somewhere. So this time, he's just gonna...
He did manage
to launch the nuke. Unfortunately, that does take it out of the Ghost Academy, so it's gone now.
Oh, that's unfortunate.
And here comes the Protoss army across the map, traditional Wings of Liberty, Heart of the Swarm style. Mini Death Ball. It's gonna go straight up the ramp. Who needs to worry about thirds? He doesn't have a third.
Just walking alongside each other. Oh, man. This may or may not be painful. It will most likely be painful.
Ambiguously could be painful.
Oh, God. Micro-dome.
Yeah.
Oh, snap. Well, looks like Colossae still pretty good against Marines.
Oh, brutal. Leave the last Marine alive and look, you can't do anything to harm us. Kill all your friends while you watch.
Oh, that's...
Look at that.
Oh, no.
It's like, no! No! Oh, God.
Oh, my God.
The massacre is real. Unfortunately, Crazy Chaos is now totally broke and has no Marines. And no workers, except for this guy.
Oh no, well, I think it's safe to say that Cena's actually won this one.
Yeah.
That'll be a miracle.
He's ahead, 96 supply.
Oh, it'll be funny. It'll be funny if, like, Cena was...
Probably not the best idea. Like, no, you had a good idea. Part of that, though, Chaos just actually went down to timing on your scout. Like, if you had known he was over there... Say you had just sent one Marine out a minute before you sent that Marine Ball out, you knew exactly where he was, you would have hit him probably 20, 30 seconds earlier. If there's no Colossi, you kill everything.
Oh, no. Here comes the card.
You had a good idea. It just didn't quite work.
You can do it, Crazy Cast. You can pull a miracle. You can just type the research of STIM. To be fair though, like what Crazy Cars can do right now is just type GG now or Star Wars spoilers.
And then your opponent's like, I've already seen it. You're like, no.
No. Alright, there he is, GG. Got him.
Yeah, I should have done something better. Again, Chaos, you didn't have a bad strategy. Just gotta practice. You had a good idea there. Like, that almost works.
Gotta do what you gotta do, man.
Don't abandon ship just because you messed up once. Just look for a tiny little thing to make it better next time.
No, right? Dude, you know what they say? Like, if you just believe in yourself, you can do anything, dude. You can do literally anything.
Well, it's not believing in yourself. You just go back and tweak it, you know?
Yeah.
Day 9 daily style.
But you also need the heart. You need the power of heart.
Well, you do need that too, but, you know, like... If you don't have any, you probably won't even... Oh, look, you got on the ladder. You have heart. As far as I'm concerned.
Oh, yeah.
So we do a best of 69 show match now. No, I am not casting that. But you can do it for fun if you want.
Oh, God, dude. Best of 69? Oh, snap. Well,
That would take actually an entire day to cast.
Yeah,
like 24 hours.
I would not be up to playing that, because I hate sitting.
However, if you do this with each other for fun, you will get a ton better. I guarantee that.
Ah.
You force yourself to play that much, you're going to be really good.
Cast it for me? No. No. Just no. I mean, yeah, I know, man. I just want to do something.
But yeah, in all seriousness, I think you guys did a really good job. This was actually a pretty solid matchup between the two of you. You had a really close series every single time. So, the thing is, I think the gap between you and the nearest next person may be a little large. I'll see what I can do. Maybe I'll pair you guys up with somebody who's like maybe in silver or gold, give you the chance to play against somebody a little bit better, and then rematch you guys again in the future, because I think this is just such a solid matchup that it would be good to see you guys play each other again sooner rather than later. But
oh, you're still going to eat your shoe.
No, you don't got to eat your shoe.
You know, I gotta do it, dude. Does he have the Twitter?
Oh, I'm sure he has access to
it. Alright. Oh shit. You know what I'm gonna do? I'll be right back, you know, hold on.
Okay. Well, anyway, while Manbun is eating his shoe, I'd like to thank everybody for hanging out this weekend. Watching these different matches. Of course, glad I got to participate myself finally. It was fun. It's given me a new focus for practicing myself, so I hopefully actually get better at this game finally. And basically, got another 2 weeks before the next set of matches hit, and I'll be working on the VODs tonight, so hopefully those will go up pretty quick.
Yes.
Not really too much else to cover housekeeping-wise, so we are done for the weekend.
Practice games.
You guys have a wonderful evening and a great week.
Next week, just practice games, I think.
Yeah, there is.
Yes.
Practice game Saturday, 2 p.m. Eastern.
Yes.
Just show up here. That's the requirement.
Yes.
That's the entry requirement.
That's good.
Show up here.
Yes.
And we play. If no one shows up, then we don't play.
Yes.
Or I go play co-op with Deploy for an hour. That's what happened last time.
It
was fun, though.
Or we all play Heroes.
Play Heroes after that, yeah. I mean, whatever.
At least there was a party, man. Come on.
We had fun. Yeah, that's true. That's true. Anyway, we are done.
Catch you guys later. Bye.
Bye-bye.